Hello, James.
Hello, everybody. Has anyone done their hair and makeup for the show?
Welcome to the show, James.
You can use other
I have.
The sleep treatment.
Jess, you can help yourself. It's fine. Just eat.
Oh.
No hand.
Everyone else is here.
Oh, wait. I'm here for about 40 minutes.
Oh, like Bruno's not going to be here for a while?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
We're not waiting.
We should start him.
Oh. Yeah. You're like, Steeler's fine.
Oops, bye bye.
But the Wheel of France,
like
actually,
this.
Huh? You have to switch the mics now, also.
Yeah.
You
did
it? Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
Wow.
Sorry,
this
I'm
works.
Walking in front of the camera. If you want to add salt, there's some on the table. I didn't salt it too heavily, so.
I gotta put the other noodles in. The pasta.
Is this the right or left panel of it?
The right one. So this is the one you want to take from.
Gives wetness. That serving you just put there, that's mine. That's swap.
Swap.
Good job. So many manners, this kid.
Yeah.
I've done well.
What a player. Probably should have thought about bowls instead of plates.
Oh shit.
Yeah, probably.
That's pretty intense.
What?
The amount of vinegar.
Oh yeah, I really like vinegar.
Oh okay, so you know.
Like a weird amount. So.
Okay, that's fine.
That's why I was like, yeah, I'm dipping right in the vinegar center and swirling it around.
It's tasty.
Coral, I can see.
Oh, you can. I want a piece of bread as well.
I die.
Yeah. Or should we get another plate?
Yeah, I'm gonna grab one because I put the other bread in the oven.
Okay.
I got some more noodles as well.
Oh my god, there's so many carbs.
Yeah, but it's so good.
Oh yeah.
That's how you know it's good, is when there's a lot of carbs.
You're gonna give us all a hug.
That's fine. It's fine.
It's fine.
Obviously, this isn't something that you make every day, but it's good. Well, we make the bread every day because it's easy.
There you go.
Are you guys ready to talk about esports? No?
I'm ready to eat food.
Okay.
Because I haven't eaten
talk about the new esports game. Blizzard's game.
Nah, talk about BlizzCon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Once I'm done eating, it's really good, Andy.
Glad you like it.
I'm gonna put some vinegar. Mix. So it's just cheese and pasta.
Cheese, cream, butter, pasta.
I'm allergic to cream and cheese and butter.
That's all a lie.
And
you've eaten this
pasta.
Before. What? The other noodle should be done soon, script.
Come on.
Where's Sam?
One more.
Oh my god, we killed that pan already?
Yeah, that's why I was making two. Because I'm like... What? Stop it.
Hey, damn cheese.
This is really expensive vinegar.
It's good. It's like 30 euros.
30 euro per pot.
Wow. They eat it like every night.
They do?
Yeah.
The fuck? They wake up at like
one of these lasted us like 2 weeks and we were using it daily.
They wake up at like 5 in the morning and they're like, it's time to cook.
What do you mean wake up?
Stumble upstairs at 5 in the morning.
No, we were.
After being awake since 5 p.m.
And they make bread. And they sit here and they see who can have the most vinegar.
No, that's him.
Yeah, so Trance is here, but not here right now. He's in Stockholm.
They know where he is.
Do we know how long they're going to be?
Didn't you say like 45 minutes?
They said they would be done about now, and that in trans time means like an hour. So I guess with Bruno, it will take 40 minutes before you're here.
I will take it easy.
But it's just a wild guess, so they might be here now or in 5 hours. They're apparently building a computer at PyCup.
Yeah, they're building a PC.
I feel like another 5 minutes for bread and more pasta.
Did anyone watch BlizzCon?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I watched like the intro thing.
That was like when they announced it.
I watched Heroes of the Storm, part of the WCS, and the Overwatch thing.
What did you think of Heroes of the Storm?
From a competitive standpoint?
Well, yeah, that's the thing, because at one of the end ceremony, the guy who was talking was like, and thank you for those, you know, who, you know, played in the Heroes of the Storm show matches and, you know, showed us, you know, it's like, I just woke up, so I can't remember what the guy said, but...
Well, from a competitive standpoint...
Yeah, how competitive it was for esports.
I thought it was a bit stale. Like, there was pretty much only one-dimensional strategies employed by every single team, more or less, which was, during the early game, kind of like five men, and then you continue to five men until one team wins the game. I mean, that's what I saw, okay? I haven't played the game personally, so I don't know exactly, like, if there's ways to beat it. Like, Script has played more than me, so he says that there's ways that you can counter it. There's more being cooked right now. I mean, it'll be done this.
Sorry, Rob. And there's a different table for Asians.
That's what I kind of realized when I come out to empty play.
I don't know. I feel like it's it lacks depth.
Isn't experience shared across all the heroes on the board?
Mm-hmm.
So there's really only so much you can do with that, I feel.
Well, I guess one of the benefits to that is that instead of, like...
There's no one that's going to be, like, AFK farming for 25 minutes and then coming in, but...
Well, not just that, but in a way, split pushing kind of has a way of balancing out, because if you five-man the whole game, and you're running around just getting, like, mercenary camps or whatever, and you're trying to get big objectives, you're probably going to fall behind in experience, but the counter to that is killing forts gives you a lot of experience.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So if you get mercenaries, it's, like, it still kind of balances each other out.
You just eat the sad little end of the bread.
That's
while you watch the rest of us eat pasta.
The only thing I get.
They announced Overwatch 2, video game.
I thought Heroes of the Storm was shit.
It may need more vinegar.
Well, the game's been out for how long? I don't think we could.
It was in technical alpha since at least, like, PAX East this year.
Mm-hmm.
Probably even before. I think I played it at PAX East.
No, fuck off. Come on.
Pour it on me. Oh, pour some. Oh, yeah.
You're just about to be drinking vinegar
over here
as well. Bottles.
Yes.
Yeah. It's so good.
But we don't have any bread yet.
Oh, we don't have oil. The bread's going to be coming out in like 2 seconds.
I can see why you guys sit up all night just eating bread.
It's fucking good,
yeah,
right?
Good.
I almost think, or thought I should have bought
it. No, Andy, last night, came and knocked on my door because the internet went down at like 5, almost 6.
I was in a fucking game.
My internet went down.
I was
for everyone. And I'm like, now I'm awake. And then it's like, let's make bread. So we did.
And bread was bad.
It was glorious.
And then you didn't care about the internet anymore.
Probably the perfect time to do maintenance, like 5 in the morning on a Saturday.
Nah, yeah, it was just our internet. So
this is actually downloaded. You can pull it out. Sweet.
More bread?
Yep.
Excellent.
Lumi.
Yes.
C9 won Heroes of the Storm at BlizzCon over EG.
Great.
Is that why you're wearing a C9 hoodie today?
No, I was watching them getting all three in the summit. He's just a general fanboy. No, it's just the first thing I grabbed when I woke up.
Who did they lose to?
Secret. Secret is going, and Cloud9 is crying.
Yo, there's fucking... Just use it now.
Alright, fine.
Whatever.
So who played in EG?
Idra in LZ game.
You know who played in Fnatic?
Sase
and Naniwa.
It's like retirement gaming, isn't it?
That's what I thought as well. I'm like, keep up with the Koreans. Let's go.
I actually looked at the team page on EG's website and saw like the info for most of the players, and they're like, oh, they pretty much all came from StarCraft 2 and didn't make it. And then you went to Heroes of the Storm.
Huh? Noodles need like 2 minutes.
That's the thing about Blizzard. I don't like Blizzard anymore, really, in terms of what games they put out. Like, you know, they did, like, Overwatch, okay? So when they announced Overwatch,
it's very hot.
At some point, someone, the two people talking, I think it was like Sam, whatever his name is, not Sam, the guy who's with Cat Hunter.
I don't know. Well, you mean when they went back? Like
the guy who's like VP of story and...
I don't know.
You must know, he's really annoying. No, Chris Metzen.
Yeah.
Yeah, Chris Metzen. So Chris Metzen and someone else were on stage talking about Overwatch, and one of the things that like kind of resonated with me was like, someone said like, you know, we wanted like an FPS game that even, I think he said, my grandma could play or something, you know, my grandma could get into. And I was like, that's just the fucking problem with Blizzard.
Well, everything they're doing like, is going so casual.
Yeah, it's like, you look at the audience and you just think to yourself, it's just like, you know, it's like the people that Blizzard attract now to BlizzCon is embarrassing. And their games are just like, who the fuck says, I want to make an FPS game that even my grandma can get into? Like, why? Why? Why are you making games for your grandma? Like, what? Why? Leave your grandma alone. You know? And that's what Heroes of the Storm is. And that's what Overwatch is going to be.
If it was easy, James, everybody would do it. I mean, and that's Blizzard's MO. Has been for years.
No.
I think using the grandma term might not be like the best way to put it.
That's
but
what
if you look at League of Legends, Hearthstone, these are fairly popular games that are easy to get into. So, in terms of like a business...
They're not games, they're just like small amounts of like time-eating machines. It's like they're becoming closer. No, but they're becoming closer to mobile apps.
Well,
no, because like Dota 2 is fun because it's like difficult, strategic. It's, you know,
well,
it's got
that. Some people find other games. Some people find Heroes of the Storm fun. Some people find Hearthstone fun. You know.
Yeah, it's... I know, and you know, these are the people that I don't want to meet. You know what I mean?
Like... All right. Well, then you can have your own little James Con and not invite anyone, please. WoW anymore.
James Con.
You should have that, actually. You should host a James Con.
You're the host of James Con.
Yeah.
But you'd have
female to get in for free.
You'd have to host it.
Yeah.
That's the problem.
Only Quake.
But they piss me off.
I just look at Hotshot. It's like it's designed for like a mobile crossover from the beginning, so it's kind of shows their intent with like how they want to approach gaming now on. It's very.
Did you see the Hearthstone finals?
Yeah, top deck master.
Yep, he won because RNG.
Yeah.
Stop eating like you're in prison.
Hold on, wasn't he like?
He top decked like.
What didn't he 3-0?
Yeah, 3-0 with Druid. Mm. Top deck.
I was gonna say like the Hearthstone tournament, had it used different formats, it would have come up with various different winners based on, you know, it's like it's so silly. How long were you in prison anyway for breakfast? How long were you in prison for?
Long enough.
What did you do to get to prison?
Tried to kill Summer.
Oh yeah.
Finally got out. Just enjoying the food.
Food.
Let Lumi take first.
Let's eat all of this before the other people come back.
So VM.
Is that what you said when I was in my
That's
room
That's attack material right there.
Yeah, really, this would be a really good practical joke to play on Lumi. He'll come out for dinner and there'll be nothing left. It'd be hilarious.
Every one of those tables.
Trance would be really mad if there was no food.
Stop it, Scriff.
I don't think Bruno would be annoyed.
Yeah.
But Trance would be really mad.
Trance and food. That's like
that's what makes
food.
It fun.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying.
Imagine his little Romanian face. What? What do you mean? I could have gone to McDonald's.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to take the car in like 2 seconds.
That's actually what I would say too. That's a sad part.
Can I have some family juice, Scrip?
It's almost empty. This is my second glass of juice I've had from my juice.
That's because you've been drinking it straight out of the bottle.
No.
What is this called?
Bread?
No. Not the bread. People refer to it as...
What's wrong?
Wait, you're talking about the herbs that's on there?
The pasta.
Oh, it's just Alfredo sauce with the...
Holy shit,
Lumi is hungry.
Herbs.
I'd be impressed, actually, if he was able to eat all that.
This? You're gonna go into a food coma before you finish that.
This.
No, no. Finish it all before Trance comes in, and I'll give you €50 bonus.
Free food and money. Totally worth it.
Finish all this?
Yeah, but get people to help you.
You don't blame it on me.
No. No one would believe it, would you?
That's true.
I mean, by the time Trans will be here, you can have it for breakfast.
No. Did someone watch the Star Crash?
Hmm?
At BlizzCon?
Star Trek 1, right?
What?
Watch what?
Life Finds a Way?
Yeah.
Yeah, I watched it.
Jurassic Park?
The stage was awesome. Like,
Yeah. I saw that.
It changed and...
the stage was really, really cool.
And Red Eye was pretty good in his tux, just kept the show running.
What did you think of their, like, analyst desk?
Better than...
Tasteless sitting down, the other standing one.
No, they all sat by the end, I think.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, because I saw them after the intro.
The StarCraft 2...
If you want salt,
the StarCraft 2 people, in terms of, like, talent... were a mile ahead of every other like stage. Like the World of Warcraft people were, and the Hearthstone people were kind of learning, and so StarCraft 2 was actually like the only real show.
Mm-hmm.
Redo was fine, did some stuff. Still has a problem with not being able to connect with an audience, but bear in mind they are half his age, so some of his jokes still don't land.
Such plain.
It's just fun watching him because it's like you watch him and you're just like, oh yeah, I know what he's going to do. He's going to come up with an intro and then he's going to raise his voice for an applause and then he's going to try and say something cheeky and then it's like, kind of doesn't really work. And then he sends it off. But he did, like, I liked it. I thought his performance this time was fun. It was nice. And I thought Nick is always really good. And they rotated people a lot.
I thought
day 9 still commentates. By saying nothing, but sounds like he's saying something.
Yeah. He talks in circles, he's very good at it.
Yeah, like he just like, you just like, make an actual point, you know, like, it's, you know, it's like he sounds like he's commentating on the art of StarCraft, rather than the actual match of StarCraft.
That's actually a good way of
putting it. It's filler content.
I can't eat anymore, I'm talking full.
The closest in Apollo were good in the finals as well.
We have weapons.
Granddad
needs food.
Oh my
god.
How much do you need?
That's fine. Just that.
Put the phlegm on me.
When I'm done, I'll have another. I need to get through this.
Unbelievable.
Trans gonna kill us.
Dude, it's not our fault that he's over an hour late.
Yeah, he knew when fucking the show started.
Yeah. He's the one that complains when we're late.
Yeah.
Why isn't the show like it?
Watch him come here with McDonald's already and just be like, ah, oh, yeah, we know, we were late.
But then still complain that there's none of this left, just in case he wanted some?
Probably. I made a lot, though. I honestly didn't think...
They're probably watching right now.
I didn't think that we'd actually go through two, but we would have if they were actually here.
Yeah.
Good enough.
How was the cooking part of the show?
I don't know, I thought it was alright.
Did you come up with any kind of slogans?
No.
No.
Catchphrases?
Do I look like a slogan guy to you? I wear a hat around all the time.
Probably the first time someone actually learned how to cook it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Difference at least.
Did you like it?
People were questioning you.
I like to imagine there were people cooking along with him.
We're gamers cooking food. It's like,
you don't do that as a gamer.
We're the most questionable people you've ever seen.
Not sure if legitimate.
You ate more than I thought you would.
Have some more script.
He hates Parmesan.
You're a grown boy.
Am I dead?
You are.
Well, James, did you want to talk about Reflex? Because a couple people like keep posting, you know, it's Kickstarter progress in the Good Studio subreddit, and someone today asked if you would talk about it because it seems like it's kind of a competitor of Reborn.
No. Reflex is a CPMA clone, which is really boring because if people want to play CPMA, they can go and download Quake. So they're just a bunch of stupid Australians.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Well, that clears that up.
What about Overwatch?
That's Blizzard making a game for their grandmas.
Shouldn't be thrown to be.
Although I am kind of annoyed.
All games suck except for
some of the stuff that is in Overwatch is in my design document. But I am kind of annoyed by that. But it's fine. I also wanted to make games for my grandma. Huh? Ever watches Team Fortress?
No.
2. Mm. It's an FP MOBA. It's a first person MOBA, really. Because it's like you only have person. Yeah, you only have one gun and you have two abilities and an ultimate.
Three abilities, please.
Huh?
Three abilities. Please.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, like a movement one. Sometimes.
So essentially smite.
Oh, smite.
Yeah. Not but for grand powers.
More easily playable.
Mm.
I think it would be more appealing to say an FPS so easy that even I could play it. Because I am the world's worst FPS player.
The thing about an FPS game that makes it good, it's not like just abilities, it's how it feels and how it moves. And I can guarantee you that that game is just... You might as well play it on your mobile phone.
Don't be surprised if you can.
Hey, it's...
Oh, watch for icon.
Don't worry, love. Have a reason.
I love so hard.
Tracer. Like, the character design... here's the thing, right? The slogan of the game is like... We could always use more heroes or something, you know? Like, we could always, you know... The world could use another.
Mm-hmm.
More heroes. And here's the problem. I think that when you're doing a game like this, the way that you relate to the game is heavily through the characters. Okay? Which I think is a different way, but I don't like that way of approaching, like, an FPS game. Because I think when you play an FPS game, you as the player should be, you know, the one that people relate to. Not like I play Tracer or I play Winston or something. Just like, you know, this is me and I am better at everyone else. But I think that because the game's going to have like a low skill cap, they don't focus on the hero being the player. They focus on the player thinking they're like the hero. And that's why they put so much work into making these characters interesting and then having storyline, because you're not role-playing, you're good at an FPS game, or, you know, you're not kind of like, hey, you know, like back in the day when you were playing Quake or Counter-Strike, it's like, it's your name that matters, it's not what your enemy is. But they've taken away the focus of you and putting it into role-play of a character design, so that the relatedness to the game goes to that, and so people don't really, you know, mind if you're good or bad, because the character is what will get scrutiny in the gameplay. You know, it's like, oh, I don't like Tracer because she can do this, or I do like that.
So instead of saying, oh, that guy is really good at this game, they'll say, oh, that hero is overpowered.
Yeah, yeah, but I think that's what they almost want as well, isn't it? Because it's for grandmas. But the thing is, the slogan of the game, the world, you know, like the way they've sold it is very kind of like clever. It's like, you know, we always use more heroes, and you think yourself, and you look at those kids in the trailer, and you're like, well, they want to be the heroes, but they're like, you know, and I was like, well, that would be cool if they were, you know, like the user or something, but nah, it's not. I don't know, I don't.
Well, but it is just like Dota, like, you never want to admit that the people on the other team are better than you. It's just like, oh, they picked Ember Spirit again, and that's why it's a broken hero.
Yeah, yeah, but...
I think there would be a little bit of balance, at least at high end. Like, for low skill and medium skill, I definitely agree that people associate better with just being the character than you. But if there was ever, like, a professional level of play, there's always recognition of the player.
If this game becomes an eSport, like, it's going to be a team game, 6v6. And it's just going to be so casual. It's like, and Blizzard, I feel, are just kind of like super excited off the success of their free-to-play and Hearthstone.
Blizzard gets excited about everything that they do. Blizzard gets just really excited about everything that they do.
I was really mad, though, because they started like that whole like show segment or whatever with like the Warcraft. They were like, Warcraft 8, Warcraft 2, Warcraft 3,
yeah, like
World of Warcraft.
Years ago.
And it's like, I'm like, holy shit, it's happening. Warcraft 4,
yeah,
it's actually happening. And then
but they're
like,
they won't compete
nope.
with their own game, which is Starcraft 2, right?
Yeah, I know.
Because they killed their own franchise. So they might as well take all the shit they learned from Titan, or whatever it was called, their project, and then put it in an FPS game. But apparently what they learned was is that they can hire a lot of people from kids' games to make a good cinematic.
They do make really good cinematics.
Yeah.
Once they're done, it's StarCraft 2 though, like I said with Void.
Yeah!
They can go back.
Four!
Yeah.
I want my tower defense map space.
Because World of Warcraft.
It's coming. Yeah.
Will
it
because
be the
they
same,
implemented
man?
All the storyline from World of War or from Warcraft into World of Warcraft.
Come
that's
again?
The thing. They're
I
not going to do
Warcraft
4 because they'll just keep putting it into World of Warcraft.
Yeah, they have like 2-3 more expansions planned already.
Yeah, but that's the thing. They use like potential storylines they could have used in Warcraft 4. Like, they're using World of Warcraft instead.
Yeah.
Like, keep it going there.
Well, it's not my Warcraft.
I'll never have a new version of Element TD to play.
In Dota, maybe.
Or Anthos.
Just go to tower defense websites.
Is it gonna be the same, though?
You get really drunk.
As cute as I was back then.
You just get really drunk and pretend.
I actually
love tower defense.
I actually played Anthos like less than 7 minutes.
I regret
it.
I watched
it.
I don't know why you stopped.
I knew it as soon as I saw that.
I have not
thought
he was looking at
that.
Insane.
You have considerably. It's a break.
Oh,
you're taking a break? No, that's not good. Like if you actually want to eat it all, you need to eat it fast, like weapons. Just like fucking like.
And then just like regret it.
Yeah, because
20 minutes later.
Your body doesn't actually know when it's full. And the slower you eat, the more time it has to realize. So if you eat really fast, you don't know you've actually like you're full, and then later on you feel sick.
So
that's where you need
never
to go.
That's why you
need.
That's why you need
sick.
To never stop.
Yeah.
I was full 5 minutes.
You're a bristleback. Never stop.
Dude,
keep diving.
Trance and Bruno
three.
Can eat it when they come here tomorrow because apparently that's how long it's gonna take them.
Yep.
You sound like an upset mother.
I cooked all this food. And
it's like
show up.
No. It's not about the food. Actually, it's just like how can you be so late?
Because Trance is never been on time.
But he's like super anal about being on time.
He was on time like once when he was like supposed to pick me up, and I was like, "Hey, wait, he won't be here." And then like exactly at the second he rang, and I was like, "Oh, he's on time." Never happened before.
And Bruno's a little bit slow as well.
Mm.
Yeah, but he's like the 5-10 minutes late guy.
Yeah.
He's not the I'm 2 hours late.
No, he's
guy.
Like
he's always the last out of the door.
Yeah.
It's like if you're going out, it's like
he's like, "Oh, we're leaving in 5 minutes. Better go take a shower."
Yeah, it's the Argentinian.
No. Bruno comes to me. We're leaving in 20 minutes. I wake up, I take a shower, I'm done. And I'm like, I look at Bruno, he's sitting in his shorts only. I'm like, Bruno, we're leaving now, aren't we? He's like, oh yeah, I'm coming. and I woke up 20 minutes ago.
Yeah, it's the same for me. He actually comes every single day during the week, like Monday to Wednesday. He'll knock on my door, or Lumi's door first, and then I'll come out and be like, are you awake? I'm like, I'm literally awake every fucking day. You are always the last one to leave the house. Why are you checking on me?
Who's this?
Bruno.
Oh.
But he's so nice. He's so nice, though. Because he goes and checks you and Lumi. And then he goes and take a shower. And then he checks me. Because he's like, ah,
it's like I hear him coming
more
up the stairs. And I'm just playing out
the
scenario in my mind. It's like, okay, I can hear him. He's walking this way, the floor is pretty creaky, he's gonna knock on Lumi's door, Lumi's awake, I know I heard him already. He's gonna knock on my door, he's still gonna be late. Okay, good. Normal day.
You say it very nicely to him, you're like, yeah, I'm ready.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it. I'm never late.
Oh. Lumi.
Like, when Lumi and I left,
Lumi,
we were early.
Lumi can be late as well, because he's sitting in a fucking Hearthstone or something.
Look, I'm playing Priest versus Priest, right? Like, it's just control, and both decks are fatiguing, and nobody's dying because they're healing.
What did you make of the BlizzCon Hearthstone finals?
I actually enjoyed watching the games. I'm not sure. Like,
they got top
the
deck,
whole
right?
The whole RNG thing, like, people complain about it, but I think
it was pretty stupid RNG, though. Like, some of the top decks he got was like,
I think a trading card game is a game of percentages. So when you play really
so it was
well,
pure skill, is that what you're saying?
I'm not saying it's pure skill. There's definitely luck in it.
Game needs, like, best of five with sideboard.
Yes, I agree. Sideboard is gonna be good.
What's sideboard?
Sideboard is basically, like, you have 40 cards or 30 cards in a deck, and then you have another, like, 20 cards or something that's on sideboard that you can switch between games, so you can change your deck depending on what matchup you're in.
So I think 30 and, like, maybe 7 or 5 would be good.
But that's the thing, with them adding more cards, it's...
Yeah, the
goblins and gnomes.
Yeah, gnomes and goblins.
Just, dude, I looked at some of the cards.
I think that would change a lot, though, because you could have some transforming sideboards. Like, you could change your warlock from aggro to maybe semi-control. I don't know.
Yeah, like,
it seems like you need to bring too many cards out.
Like, Sue early and then, like, control.
But it would make it more fun to watch.
Definitely.
Then it's like, you can get top deck maybe once out of five games, but the probability of it...
Oh no, top deck still exists.
Yeah, it still exists, but it's not going to be like as prevalent. Because the more games you play, statistically, the less chance you have to get top decked, and then you can continually change your deck.
I just think they need to increase the amount of cards you have in your starting hand, and then add lots and lots and lots more cards, so people can design decks that are played for in very specific ways, but can actually play them, because they start with like one more card at the beginning, and it lowers the, you know, makes the chances of being able to start like how you're meant to play the deck.
Higher. Yeah. That's.
And I think with more cards, you just add a larger uniqueness, because it's so boring watching people play like Druids. I mean, you know, everyone's like, and people are like, you're watching it, and it's like, okay. It's
Turn one Yeti.
And the thing is, it's like, the casters have to get excited about the fact that he didn't put in, you know, a Sylvanas, you know, because like that's like, you know, or. Harvest Golem or something, you know, like those little differences in like the Druid decks is like what's, you know, big, because you're not,
but I also think like even if you added one more card, that would just make sideboard even more interesting, because even though the probability of drawing something better is cool, having the capability of going between games and having like, oh man, he can change to this and this, there's like 20 different possibilities that he could possibly take. You know, I think it just adds more to the experience for the viewer as well, and it makes people who commentate the game not have to just theorycraft all of it, which kind of seems like what it is. Because you know, actually know what the person is going to draw. So basically your best bet is, okay, this is best case scenario, and then these next three are
what else? Is that what Blizzard is targeting, though? Like, is adding sideboard going to make the game too complicated, such that...
I don't think so.
People are going to be like...
They're currently educating the soccer mums.
Why can't you have
the
more
soccer mums have been hooked? You know, everybody that you know, like.
The thing is, why?
And then they
why
add more cards,
more
and people learn Zuka.
Like, look at Dota, where you have all pick captains, mode captains, draft, like all different modes. Like, why can't you have that for Hearthstone? If so, like, you can have a normal one. Like, and then you have one that's maybe set for competitive play, that like the community decides, oh, this would be best for competitive, which is casual mode in Dota.
Yeah, because like casual people still don't really play constructed because it costs money. They play Arena, because it's like, I think...
Yeah, they just do the quests.
I think that people play Arena if you're casual. So the constructed, like, ranked mode is your one way of being competitive. But if they actually allowed, like, rule sets, the community might come up with stuff. But unfortunately, if you're going to add, like, sideboard, it needs work from the development team to actually add the options in. But at least you could probably play with the idea of, like... deck size, you know, you like you imagine the variables you could change, right? So it's like deck size, you know, like 50 cards, you know, why not? You could have 50 health if you wanted to. You could also have starting hand, you know, maximum cards that you can hold. You know, all those variables are pretty easy to tweak for a coder, because it doesn't change anything on the graphics side apart from, you know, the...
I mean, even with a sideboard game, like if you guys are doing another tournament, you could just have them submit their deck list.
Yeah,
and the sideboard, and then, you know, they could swap between, and obviously we could check to make sure that that's... I think that's actually really interesting.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a backdoor way of doing it, but...
Yeah, well, you kind of have to do it if you want to get something in like that, because they're not going to listen straight to you, and then if it's successful and Blizzard notices it, then they're maybe going to implement it.
Yeah.
But
Blizzard also boasted this was, like, one of their best years for esports. And they actually said in the final speech that they felt it's, you know, become more of like an esports Olympics, BlizzCon.
Oh.
And then and they gave a three quarters of $1,750,000 over at BlizzCon. But everything was really funny, because if you look at the branding of stuff, right? If you looked at the esports tournament, it says like Hearthstone World Championships, World of Warcraft World Championships, and then it was like Heroes of Storm, you know, exhibition, whatever. And then you go to WCS, the shittest tournament of like the whole like year of like in terms of like branding and what people like, you know, messaging, and WCS Championship Series StarCraft 2, and it's just like. If you're actually looking at it from a you know, like, might maybe not abbreviate the WCS part, you know, because it's World Championship Series, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, so they had it as WCS Grand Finals or something, or Final something.
I think it's Grand Finals.
Yeah. And it's just like, well, why not just call it World, you know, World Championship Series, you know, something, rather than... Because it just looked really wrong, the messaging.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
There's a lot.
But yeah, they kind of boasted about it a bit, and, like... It wasn't much of a boast. I think you just say stuff like that when you're on stage because you've got a big audience. But
yeah,
you're
you
certain
shit, right? You can't go up and say like, "Oh, we're not as happy as this one as you would like." But
no, but
e-sports
they were talking about like the
decline,
whole of esports.
But...
but I was just watching the people in the crowd after, when they were talking about like the esports and who won, like Life won, and you know all that kind of stuff. Fireback, Cloud9, and some dudes from Europe won World of Warcraft. And I was just looking at the audience, and I was just like, half of them don't give a fuck. Like, they literally are just there because it's BlizzCon.
Someone told me, like, it gets bought up by World of Warcraft fans all the time, and like 70% of the BlizzCon audience
is
World of
Warcraft.
Warcraft.
Yeah, yeah,
it might be true or not, I don't know, but that's what people told me.
No, it is. Because all the Americans, they got guilds, so that's actually where they would go meet. It's like the excuse to go
the
meet.
Guild meet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because they even have like guild meetup times
organized.
I don't think World of Warcraft fans are exactly your esport demographic for the majority.
Not really. They managed to kill Arena, so.
They're good at killing esport episode.
Yeah.
It's their specialty, they really know how to do it.
What's happening with StarCraft 2 next?
Legacy of the Void.
Okay.
They finally invented a game mode for Legacy of the Void that even I can play. It's Archon mode. Basically means that it's like half and half control. So one person, like, I guess you control the base, and then the other person controls the army.
You're both playing as one.
Ah,
oh.
Yeah.
They had it in
Exemplish
awesome. Like 15 years ago.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
It's basically,
Walk
it's like, if you feel this shit RTS games, you can now play with another person to make you less shit.
Thinking RTS is too complicated,
yes.
Then we're going to dumb it down for
no,
you.
I like this thing, that's fun.
Now your grandma can play.
The concept of any kind of, like, co-op is fun.
Yeah.
And you have to admit, like,
okay.
Even if you allowed two pros to play at the same time, you would have this amazing kind of, like, strategies that a single person couldn't pull off.
Yeah.
So it would actually be more interesting. Also, if people streamed on Twitch TV playing Archon mode, you would actually be interested in listening to StarCraft 2 players. Because StarCraft 2 players, you don't want to listen to, you know, much, because it's like, they're just telling you, like, you know, what build order, you know who they're going to kill. And it's like, well, if you actually listen to two StarCraft 2 players communicate and talk to tactically beat the opponent, you would actually be listening in to something that's really cool.
Yeah.
I mean, I designed a Hearthstone tournament, which was a co-op Hearthstone tournament, and I designed a mode in Reborn, which was called Wingman, where two people would actually play co-op FPS in a way, but they would have different abilities and they wouldn't share the same stuff. And it was purposely designed for entertainment purposes and enjoyment of co-op. So it's not a bad idea, the Archon mode. But it's...
They also,
I would play it.
They also made Legacy of the Void standalone. So
what?
You buy Legacy of the Void,
you don't need the other.
Yeah. You get the...
You don't need StarCraft 2 or Horde of the Swarm.
Well, that's a good thing.
Well, that just makes sense, because each time a company puts out an expansion pack, if you have to have, like, at least the base game and all the expansions before it, then you know that your consumer base for that new expansion is going to be, at the very most, everyone who has all the previous games,
and
very likely most of them are not going to buy it. So
I've been like interested in trying World of Warcraft sometimes, and every time I go, I said, okay, I have to buy like 4 expansions.
Yeah.
And you're like, ah.
They do. I feel like they do keep doing deals every once in a while where it's like something like $60.
Yeah, but
for
it's
like
still
the base
$60 for
the...
like, you know.
Yeah.
It's an expansion.
As opposed to just taking the expansion and
using that.
So. Yeah.
They should just do that. Like after a year, just make the expansion the whole thing.
Yeah,
that
makes sense.
That's kind of what they do.
But then they have to give something to the people that did go through and buy the base game and the expansions, because then they feel ripped off if they're like, well, over my life I spent $120.
Yeah, but everybody that's super dedicated will be happy if they get like a special amount for that.
That's true.
And they'll be like, yay.
Damn cosmetic users, man.
I get an extra amount.
Have you played Archon World Dota?
That's what?
One person on mouse, one person on keyboard.
Oh my god.
That sounds awful.
Persian, I play Invoker, Archon World. Actually, no, it was Food Runner.
I feel like anything requiring micro would be really funny.
Yeah, it would be
that
funny.
Way, like, it would be impossible to do.
We were streaming it, and, like, because James was saying, like, you know, people are interacting, but we were just saying, oh, man, you suck, you miss micro, blah, blah, blah. So that actually made it really fun to play, because...
Yeah, but it could be like in Age of Empires a lot of years ago. If you put yourself in the same player, you could control the same like army base thing. It was really funny. The game would be
it was so much harder, really funny. So fucking hard to play.
Yeah, yeah. But it was still like a fun mode if you were trying to learn a friend or something that didn't know. Like you could really like.
Age of Empires was a funny game.
Yeah, it is.
It was really good.
Freaking Camel Riders, man. So OP. I forget which race I actually got.
Did the new Sid Meier's come up, by the way? Did Beyond Earth?
Yep.
Yeah,
it's like a week ago, right?
It's actually really good, but
yeah.
It's still like the thing that happened with 5, you know, when 5 was released, that it lacked a lot of functionality from
the previous
games. Yeah,
and then like Gods and Kings came
in. Exactly. So now
yeah,
it's like,
really
it's come to the point where 5 has like really good depth if you play it a lot. You can really do a lot of stuff, you can try a lot of tactics, it's kind of balanced, they break it sometimes, but it's good now. While I feel like Beyond the Earth is like back to Civilization 5 again, where it's like, you have these three things you can do, and it feels very limited in how you want to play it, and you have to like kind of commit very hard compared to, like,
what's that? You don't want to go to war? Oh, you're dead next turn.
So if you would recommend, you would recommend...
Depends on if it, the thing is, Beyond Earth, they really made a good job like reinventing Civilization again, like in terms of how they created it. So it's a really good game, but if you're starting from scratch, I mean, you could start with it and run the expansions, but if you come from, like, you know, played a lot of Civilization,
mm-hmm.
it feels very, like,
you feel too
stale.
You,
yeah,
take
exactly.
a, you take a step back.
Yeah.
Well,
it's
that's
like sort of too.
Interesting, though, because I never really played a lot of the Civ games. So, like, you're saying I could just jump into Beyond Earth and actually.
Yeah, of course. I mean, the Civilization games is always like that. You can always, you know, somehow start somewhere. But in terms of how long it can go and, you know, how long it keeps on being fun, that's what I felt like Beyond the Earth is lacking, because it maxes out so quickly compared to what you can do in the current Brave New World expansion for Civilization 5.
Yeah.
Do we finish your dinner?
Yeah, people in chat were really angry. I told
too big
you,
for your
britches,
man.
I'm not even done yet.
Are you still taking that break?
Yeah.
Like,
no.
How long is the break gonna last?
Maybe like 4 hours.
4 hours, yeah.
Four.
So right on the time that transit runner get here, you're gonna be like, just in time.
Yeah. Let's. I'm gonna eat with them again.
Yeah. You mean still?
More dinner party.
Yeah, still.
In for that.
Well, does anyone want to talk about CS:GO?
Oh, it's in the Fragment Massive somewhere, though.
Did anyone watch CS:GO?
No.
Yeah, I watched like.
I haven't watched. No.
The last 5 minutes of a game.
I was busy watching Smash.
Yeah. True. Going along.
Canada.
Is that Swedish player that just got picked up by Alliance?
Armella, yeah.
Finally.
Who is that really young kid who's like 17 that I couldn't remember the name of?
Leffen?
No.
Isn't he like 17?
No.
RTC? Isn't he like 14?
Yeah.
Wait, what did you guys write this
for?
No, we didn't write this. We started talking about Civilization and Age of Empires.
I don't write BlizzCon. I give it a 4.
Out of 10?
25?
Out of 100.
A million.
Was that the last?
1100. No, 10.
No, was that the last?
400.
Yeah.
1100. Yes.
After you.
Give me some.
Okay.
Family juice.
Mm. It's the good bit as well. So.
Apple juice.
Rawr.
Yeah.
And then,
I mean,
what
the BlizzCon interest of. Pretty cool. Like,
it's
all
backwash.
Yeah, but
can
some of you,
glass of juice?
Some of the people at this table have been found guilty.
And some people are not at the table at all.
Have been found guilty of playing World of Warcraft again. Raise your hands if you're playing
shit.
World of Warcraft.
I saw you playing
Raise
yesterday.
Your hand.
I was waiting for weapons.
Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Anyone else?
Bruno?
Bruno was playing it, yeah.
It's fucking perfect. Why the fuck are you playing World of Warcraft?
What's wrong with WoW?
I mean, I never played it, so I don't know. What's wrong
it's
with
like,
War?
It's worse. It's like, I'd rather... I was telling him off about playing Arcage. I was like, no wonder we don't do fucking anything at the studio. Me and Bruno, like, work and then you're playing Arcage. I'm like, and then you're like, oh no, it's alright, I'm playing World of Warcraft, because I stopped playing Arcage.
Yeah.
That doesn't work. It's like, it's just
the same shit.
I
like that the first part was that you and Bruno work, when really I think Bruno's the one doing all the work.
Let's be honest here, James. You slept until after I had already fully cooked.
It's fucking Sunday.
So you can sleep until 8 o'clock?
Yes. It's Sunday. I checked my emails. I had no emails. It was a good day.
I just like,
cleaned the whole kitchen.
I cleaned last week, but well done, Jess. You're a superstar. With Andy, I cleaned last week. Because he didn't play well. And he had time to clean.
I set up everything.
Yeah, that's true. But you're still playing well. What do you get out of it?
Sitting talking shit with friends.
That is WoW, actually. It's like, it's just a chat room with a character. Like, that's what WoW is. There's nothing interesting enough in the game itself to keep you playing by yourself, because you would never play WoW if you didn't have other people who were playing it. But if you have friends who are playing it, then it's like,
it's a social thing.
I'm gonna take my brain out. And
put
I'm
it over here.
My friends.
It's something that's like mindless. You don't have to think. Good,
I think maybe
WoW, you don't have to try.
Yeah, I think my perception of gaming then is different than other people, because I play video games to get away from people. That's why I only play solo MMO. It's like I don't join parties because I don't want to talk to people.
I think you're just a hermit. We're gonna have to build you like walls in here.
I like these black covers.
We should put up like extra fence in there.
What do you get?
Dude, just give up.
Weapons.
You cannot
defeat
them.
What's
the play with them?
Well,
there are starving children in Africa, Lumi.
They're sharing you on, Lumi.
Where do you
mind
doing
something?
Sharing
you
on. Finish it.
How many hours do you play per session?
You could do
more.
Yesterday I played maybe one or two. Today I played maybe 30 minutes. The rest.
Food to fall of what? Of what?
Okay, regardless whether
do
it for Cloud Nine.
No, regardless of whether I finish or not, starving African children will still be starving African children.
It's very true.
So, I don't even feel guilty.
Take a plastic bag, put the food in there.
Surely it's cold by now.
Yeah, it's not very good.
It probably,
now that
I would say
it
probably doesn't
like
even taste very good.
You're not supposed to let it sit around for 30 minutes before you eat it.
Food is
he wasn't criticizing.
No, I'm just like.
Sanjay's there, your cooking was being attacked.
I think maybe it's my perception of gaming that's warped. Because when I play games, I have like a goal or an objective. And
you played WoW before.
Yeah, but
like,
I don't.
I'm going to gear 7 hunters or whatever.
And I don't understand people. I'm quite sad, I think, because I don't understand people that play games just like for fun. And
definitely warped.
The funny thing is, like, I was in town and this guy was making this video game from another company, and he came over and he was telling me about his video game, and I was like, so what's the goal? And he's like, and I was like, oh, so the goal is just really to spend time and have fun. I was like, that's weird. I was like, yeah, I'm not gonna play your game. Like, what can I do? Can I be the best at it? He was like, nah, it's just, you know, have fun. And I'm like, don't think it's gonna sell, mate.
Doesn't sound great. This whole fun thing you're talking about is way left of center.
Yeah, okay, maybe it's me. Maybe you can play well, but it's good that you're playing less. There's a good website, actually, called Steam Tracker or something, steamtracker.com, and it shows you, like, because you know you get Steam stats. The thing about Steam stats that they don't tell you was what was it like last month or 6 months ago. Mm. And there's a website where this guy tracks video games. And he tracks their, like, you know, on a monthly basis how they've been doing on Steam, so you get everything. So it's really interesting. So I checked Quake Live, and it started off on launch, and it was, like, peaking around 5K players. I think it was actually meant to be more, because I'm pretty sure I saw it at 10. And now it's losing 22 to 30% of its audience on a monthly basis. And it's peaking at 1K player, which is what it was peaking at before. But but at least it's peaking on weekdays as opposed to weekends.
Mm. So people are actually playing after work and stuff.
Yeah. But it's less and less.
Yeah.
Huh?
Fast is streaming it a lot.
Yeah. He played a show match against Sparty Faz, and he won $40, $10 per map. He won 4-3 over Sparty.
Damn. don't have any idea who they are.
But they were promoted on the front page of Twitch for some reason, and Faz's stream was, and so people were coming in and going, "What the fuck is this? Why are you on the front page?"
What is this game you speak of?
Faz is really cool.
Yeah.
Hey, Sudroy was streaming yesterday.
Was he?
He was in chat.
He had a Reddit thread.
And yeah, and he's got this robot, and this robot kind of sits at the end of his, like, he's facing like that, and then he's got this robot here. And the robot, you can make it talk. It's called like Joybot or something. So you type an exclamation mark Joybot, and then what you want it to say, and it will speak, and it will also move its like mouth. So people were just spamming backslashes. So when Sujoy was playing, he was just going backslash, backslash, backslash. And if you wanted to say Sujoy, you can't write his name up properly. You have to write S00 and then Joy, because otherwise it's like
Sujoy.
Yeah, so good Sujoy. And
he's so good.
Yeah, he said he wants to visit to learn the art of streaming. I'm like, you're not gonna get very good like ideas from us. But the funny thing is, like, the fact that he has a robot is made me laugh, because I don't think I've told Bruno yet, because Bruno wanted to build a robot. He wanted like 500 euro, and he was trying to get it from like Twitch, right, as an experiment. And the idea of the robot was that Bruno makes a robot that's controlled by the Twitch chat. So Twitch chat can drive the robot round and move it, and it has an arm with a camera on that you can aim. And he wanted to build it and put it on the top floor here, so people could drive it around and try and look at like Jess's skirt or something. And I was going to put a sign on my door saying "fuck off, perps," like really low down, so when the robot came, because it could have like free reign. But I thought it was a really good idea, because if you had a robot like that that Twitch chat could control, and it would like a sub would get control of it, and then it would go like, you know, anarchy or then democracy, you know, in terms of like where people were voting, what it does, you could build it, and then you could take it to like DreamHack, right? So Twitch chat could drive round DreamHack on a robot, but you build like a proper robot, like
I was gonna
a
say,
massive,
yeah,
like
big,
a big robot
one
with like a camera on it.
They
as
would
well
just drive it down
yeah
stairs.
Or you build
like literally,
yeah,
like, oh, look,
yeah, but that's
stairs.
That's the, yeah. Imagine like watching the adventures of the Twitch robot, just like at Twitch, the DreamHack, it would just be like people be trying to get into the girls' toilet. They try and drive it down the stairs. They try and steal stuff from like the Steel Series booth. Would be like, use arm, grab, run. But I thought it was like a really good idea, and like, because I thought it would be really fun for like the, like, because even if you had the stage at DreamHack, so you had like a stage, you wouldn't have to put it on the stage. You could actually build an area around the audience where the Twitch robot could be, and you could write like Twitch on it, and then people can get photos taken with it and stuff. But I think it would be really creepy when you gave it to, like, you know, Reinforce, one of the subs, and he just like scope out all the girls in the audience or something.
Jesus.
So it could be creepy, but Sujoy already did a robot now. So if Bruno gets to do his robot, he said he can do it. He said he could do a little one for 500.
Combine the both, and it could be a robot going around speaking.
Yeah. Exactly. With Sujoy's Joybot,
yeah.
With Bruno's moving arm robot. Imagine people having conversations with Twitch chat. Imagine if they don't know, like, you've got this Twitch robot going around just being the most racist, sexist, douchebag motherfucker at DreamHack.
Goes up to a group of people and be like, backslash.
You wouldn't even do that, though. You'd go up to, like, at DreamHack, there's this, like, there's always these, like, 40-year-old women who work in the Elmia, and they have their own little office area with a little kind of like glass thing that you can go up to. Send the Twitch robot there, and then Twitch would be like, just, yeah.
There's no way they would be able to actually control that, though. Like, look at Twitch Plays Pokemon.
No, no, you can, because you can give it to like a sub to control by himself.
Oh, so if it's one person.
Yeah, or
okay,
no, or you can
like
have anarchy,
okay.
Or you can have, you know,
democracy.
Someone says, please don't make a Twitch robot. It's like giving a nuclear bomb to a retard.
I think it's brilliant.
Can you imagine going up to a big person and go, when he starts walking backwards, he goes, beep, beep, beep.
Because me and Bruno actually work for Twitch, and so Bruno was like making this trying to happen, and they didn't give him 500 euro for his Twitch profile. But they should.
You're so close, Lumi.
I believe in you.
What, like he's not an imaginary person?
No. As in, she believes he's going to fit
it. Oh, okay.
He's He's given up like
I believe
times.
You can do it.
Well, that's fine.
I don't believe in you, though.
Prune
and
run.
You just have to put it all in your mouth, and then you're done.
You look like you're struggling. Don't clean
that's,
up when
that's
someone
like,
else is
that's
still
like
eating.
One bite.
What?
Rude.
Yeah, that's
one bite.
You want to clean?
You just like put it
no,
all
no,
in
no,
your
no.
mouth.
Good talk.
Good talk.
That's big. You done?
Yeah. Thank you.
Wait. How come she gets to leave
okay,
food?
Okay, you're not done.
Hey,
she
no leaving
she
food.
There was no verbal agreement that she was going to eat everything.
Yes, there is. When you said that at the table.
I left
food.
Binding
five
noodles. I left five noodles.
Think of the children.
It's five noodles, and they're like...
Yeah, and Lumi's got like eight noodles left.
Can we give them to
Lumi? Lumi, help her out.
You can.
It's just five noodles.
I need a band.
It's just five noodles, Lumi.
It's fine.
This is all sit and stare in silence.
DPM's like, finally, he's eating properly. Twice his body weight of pasta and carbs.
You get a heart attack, Lumi? I ain't taking you to the hospital.
Why would you get a heart attack from that?
Carbs. He nearly had a heart attack when he went running with Waga.
He was outside for less than 5 minutes. Comes
it was like 10.
Dude, it was like 5 minutes.
Well, okay, and do you, like, if you're not used to running,
and it was
why
knowing.
Would you run with Waga? He can run so far.
No, he was going at my pace. It was like, you set the pace.
And he was just walking along.
No. I felt bad if I just, like, kind of walked, right? Normally when I go run by myself, I would walk more than I run. But I felt
bad. That's not going running.
Yeah, that's like...
It's going walking.
We're running in between.
That just looks suspicious. I mean, if I was to see you around my neighborhood, kind of, you know, all of a sudden...
Start running for no reason?
Like, why is that kid running for no reason?
See, I think running is all about
willpower.
What's
he running from?
Really,
it's just about willpower, right? So, because Waga was next to me, I would feel really guilty if I just made him walk, because he invited me out to run, so I actually ran a lot more.
It's not a nice thing for someone to invite you out to run. It's not like...
They care about your well-being. It's the same reason I won't buy you cigarettes when I go to the grocery
store.
No water.
It's like punishment.
What's wrong with water?
It's gonna fill up
fill
the stomach.
Up. I'm already filling
up. You gotta think of it like those hot dog eating contests where they like eat the hot dogs and the buns separate and they just drink water to make sure it goes down.
No.
Oh, they dip. Yeah, that's
no,
right.
No, wait. This is the thing. My mum hosted a world championship eating contest or whatever at Wookiee Hole or something where she worked. I know it was world championships. But anyway, there was this Japanese girl there. And basically what she did was, in this eating contest, she drank Sprite because it would help her throw up.
Isn't it the point of eating contest not to throw up?
I don't know.
Doesn't that disqualify?
That's not allowed.
You can't
disqualify.
Well, apparently she had Sprite.
And then don't they watch you for like half an hour after?
Yeah, you're not supposed to
throw
up.
Well, maybe you're supposed to.
Well, maybe.
Maybe
my mom was lying. Maybe it was just some random Japanese woman just like, this is my thing.
She's putting on a seminar.
She was
for
just
bulimia.
A bulimic that happened to wander by.
That's awful. You're not supposed to throw up. That's so rude.
Wait.
Maybe this
is made the hot dogs.
Maybe it was a throwing up competition. My mom was telling me about it ages ago. She was like this little Japanese woman
drinking
Sprite.
How did we come here?
Because we ran out of things
to be.
No, Eight Mother in esports. Is not now standing in for Alliance, and I think they're gonna.
That's like last week.
I think they're gonna ask.
The highest KDA in Alliance ever.
Yeah, to come back for them one more time.
The only problem is Lotus jealous of my hair, so I think that's. I mean, he has to get over it. That's why I'm not getting invited.
The jealousy factor.
Yeah.
I think weapons at him. Better chance than you, James.
We might need to actually, like, carry
you. Weapons, like, would make people want to kill themselves. Of his own team. It's alright if, like, if there was, like, an open mic, and you could talk to the other team, I would put Weapons in my team, because he's so fucking depressing. When he plays Dota, the other team would be like, fuck this, we're done. Like, you've sucked the joy out of all of us.
Oh my god.
It's like, we don't even want to kill you anymore because it's so depressing what you say that we're just done. You win, we leave. But because there's only one way comms with your own team, no chance.
Pretty much.
Like, if you watch the PPD
video where he like plays Dota and he complains. It's like he's worse. Like
sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes. And then he has to make an effort to be nice. That's the weird thing. Or to be tolerant. I like the way I've destroyed this conversation. Oh, well done, Lumi.
How are you feeling?
You're reporting your mouth shut.
Okay. So someone, humbly I submit a list of news for Good Meal to discuss. BlizzCon did, Overwatch did, CSGO, Fifth Round leaving, Nip, Michelele joining. I guess you guys don't even know who Michelele is. He played in some Swedish teams and he's joining Nip instead of Fifth Round.
Mm.
So after 2 years, Fifth Round actually leaves.
Did he leave or get kicked?
No, he left. Well, they probably came to a mutual agreement that didn't work out anymore. But,
okay.
Yeah.
But do you know the company behind NIP and who they are? Clutch Entertainment. Maybe they.
Well, everyone's slowly leaving.
I'm staying.
Right.
My show now. I buddied everyone off.
Yeah.
Good job, Weppes.
And then ESL announced the CSGO Pro.
What was CSGO Pro?
I don't know.
This is the best news show ever.
League with $50,000 starting in December. It's pretty cool.
Oh, okay. Leagues, yes.
Yeah.
That will bode well for them.
Oh, CSGO Pro League, yeah.
Hmm.
I thought it was CSGO Pro, and then
$50,000
League of Legends with $50,000.
Does the prize money get increased, do you think? Yeah, it must do.
Probably, yeah. Dota first stage of
the
league.
Do they do that for CSGO,
finish?
Though?
Yeah, they do,
yeah.
With the cases.
Yeah,
yeah,
but isn't that
cases.
For the Valve one?
No, I think...
Or
no,
they
have it for other ones. No, maybe it was only majors. I don't know. I think they did it for all of them, but I'm not sure. Because I think it,
I only
they
thought
did it
they,
for
so far. So far, I only
who's
thought...
Who's ESL's casters?
For CSGO?
For CS. Is it Red Eye? And...
Red Eye... Pansy's doing casting for it. Do they have... They have one more guy that works at ESL that does casting, I think, and then they have external talent, I think.
ESL, hiring the most exciting casters, you don't really know who they are.
Yeah. And then Dota
News... Yeah, because Face It has...
DDK
and
James.
Brandl.
Yeah.
And Room on Fire is Sandler and Anders.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Gwyn Studio is...
Me. I cast Counter-Strike Go every Thursday. I don't stream it. I just sit at home casting.
For yourself.
Yeah.
For those of us in the house to watch.
Kind of there.
It's like movie night.
Yeah.
Sorry.
And then first stage of Dream League finished. Alliance is out. Chessie's still missing. From what I heard, he's still got back problems. That's why he hasn't joined.
Chessie is not playing for who?
Chessie's missing from Alliance because he's had back problems. That's why Ape Mother was a standard. And now Ape Mother's not a standard anymore, but Chessie's still not back.
I don't have back problems. I can carry a whole team.
Yeah, and then Goblack joins Na'Vi. He plays as FNG.
FNG.
Yeah.
He gets replaced during an event that they won.
Mm-hmm.
Dendi was basically like in depression though. Like that's what it felt like from hearing stories of Star Ladder. It's like Dendi's there going, yeah, kind of like, you know, I want to win again. And
Did you read Poppy's AMA?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
He talked about the whole Na'Vi thing, where they're like... someone asked, like, do you think Na'Vi's gonna pretty much go under now when you left? Where it's like, no, they're probably just gonna go back to, like, old school, kind of like when they were DTS and stuff. So that's why Goblack's probably joining the team again. Because that's, like, the old lineup they had. So they're going back to, like, old school, they knew each other and stuff.
The guys
had
the food.
Yeah, and
yeah,
you're put
food.
Away.
Let's go.
Yes, he was back.
Had the food.
Did you already put it away?
What do you mean put it away?
Oh,
you
yeah,
shouldn't
Mandela.
Need it now, it's ass.
Yeah.
You don't want to get cold.
Mandela
heat
doesn't
back
Mandela
up
work for Room on Fire
that.
As well. Sure.
Well?
Mandela works for Room on Fire as well, right?
I'm not sure if he's like an
Oh, is that the little Swedish kid?
No, Norwegian.
Norwegian, yeah.
I'm not sure if he's just a contractor.
Hello.
I think he works with them. But
yeah,
probably
yeah.
Contractor, but he works with them.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, yeah.
Baby, are you hungry?
Back in time, be on the good meal.
Trance, are you hungry?
Fuck.
Trance.
Are you done with the show?
No. The show is live.
Oh, so
we're
you look like you just woke up.
No.
That's because he was sleeping on a couch during the show.
Do that.
Please.
Trance, are you hungry?
Yeah, I could eat, maybe, yeah.
Alright, because food's going to be ready in like 30 minutes.
Yeah.
What?
If you wait.
You're eating earlier. We saw you eating, so nice try.
Yeah.
Nice try, bro. How are you doing?
Fine.
You look tired.
Everyone else is already going to sleep, and you guys come in here.
You wanna go drinking after the show?
I might be drinking during the show.
After the show, well.
He got my fucking card blocked.
Again? You fucking call the guy. No, you can't. It's 24/7.
Then you call him and pretend to be me.
I don't know. What's your
reason? I just told off these people about what they're doing.
Right. Yeah.
And I said they've got a new disgusting habit. Right?
What was it?
You're playing World of Warcraft.
Oh yeah.
Would like to raise your hand as well to join the team.
Really?
And you he paid for World of Warcraft subscription off my company card.
Why? Because I was like, I might as well pay for a month.
Yeah.
See what happens.
So my bank's like, who's this? Like, why is he paying for some sort of Argentinian World of Warcraft subscription?
It's very cheap though. How much pesos? It's like, I think it's like 60 pesos, which is like... I don't know, it's like...
$10?
Less.
Why do you want to go out drinking?
I have to. I was just... it's frag by finals at the office.
They're drinking at the office.
And it's finished, and they're, yeah.
So they're drinking
at the
office.
That's where they're kind of... It's more like chill, you know. Some of the CS team, Semler, your good buddy Semler is going to be there.
NIP is not
Pontus.
There. They're not too good. Then.
Yeah, NIP didn't make it, sadly. So
it's like LDLC, Radic,
yeah,
a few other things.
Yeah, and that's where I have to go next, pretty much.
You're a busy man, Trans.
I'm very busy.
We went to Pycat's house.
Yeah, we built a computer for Pycat.
So
you can stream better. Quality.
His family live in...
They're not far, in Sodomo.
No. He's
his actual family, because he came to visit us.
His actual family. His mum lives there, that's where we went.
He lives
with his mum.
Yeah, his dad
and
lives
his dad lives
here.
His actual family. That sounds so
right.
Really, Yeah. We also met his brother that lives in... doesn't live here in Stockholm.
Does his brother look like him?
Oh
my god, he does.
Or does he look like another character of Final
Fantasy?
Pycat looks like...
Actually,
Cloud.
He looks like an older version of Pycat.
No. Like, Pycat is Cloud.
Yeah. And
the other one is like Snow from Final Fantasy 13, like the other blonde guy.
I didn't.
He also very similar.
I played the heterosexual versions. Final Fantasy.
No, that's Final Fantasy X-2, the one that with the girls and Barbie dress up.
I didn't see that.
Yeah, don't
know. I played X-2.
You played X-2?
Yeah, it was embarrassing.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
Let's not talk about X-2.
So what did you guys eat?
Pasta Alfredo.
Where's Andy?
Alfredo.
You had like a steak.
No, he didn't.
With bayonet sauce.
Yeah, a Greek steak.
And fries.
Double.
I know you're trying to get me to regret.
It was like... It was...
How much fat did it have?
Like quite a lot, actually. It was so tasty.
It's like juicy as well.
It was...
Medium rare. It was
so what did you... What did
Please
you cook, Andy? He's trying to fool me. He's trying to fool me.
What
did
I
cook?
Besides
the...
He's like... Alfredo is like carbonara. That's
it looked like carbonara to an extent, right? Just no bacon.
It's very parmesan cheesy sauce, that's it.
Alfredo of cream, carbonara of eggs.
Do we have a Movember thing going on now? I'm looking at everyone.
No. This is
How about you, Jess?
This is the no winter is coming, dude. That's what it's all about.
It's true. Although I don't grow full enough facial hair to really matter.
Don't fucking complain.
Oh yeah, that's true. You can only get a goat. That's fair. Yours isn't anything.
I'll come with you.
It's like reaching as hard as it can, like cliffhanger.
I guess
you
just want to go down, but it's not really a thing, is it? It's not really like a...
But I have to go down.
But you have to go
down.
I'll come with you for comfort.
Has anyone checked on Zoom?
Vincent?
Yeah, I saw.
Is he alive?
He was tweeting saying that he regretted trying to eat everything.
Yeah,
but
he's gone to his room. He's...
What, Lumi?
So?
He took like this huge plate.
He
stole
this plate.
Like, I made two pads.
Is he still being antisocial?
And he took like a third of the second one.
I remember that show when you two were just... When you're playing Hearthstone all the time on the table.
A lot.
That was the end
really
of the show.
Bad,
no, it was during the show.
What was it?
I was like, why are you there, Weapons?
Yeah.
Why didn't you interact?
No, that was when we had
like,
we started talking about the show.
He's adopted, right? He's not really a member of the family.
So is that what Asian adopted kids turn out to be?
Yeah.
Like,
I mean, it was like eating all that food was like a cry for help. And instead, we're just going out drinking now. And then we come back and beat him.
Did you notice any scars on his back and stuff?
That would be funny.
Cool.
Yeah.
So, otherwise, how's it going? Besides a nice meal?
Yeah, it's alright. We've really broken down esports in a good way. I think this show is going to be...
What did you talk about?
Dude, this show. We actually probably need to get like a list. list of things and actually have people read up the little...
Dude, we have that.
Well, we kind of did. I mean, that's like where all the topics we were coming from tonight, we were taking directly from either
chat or
Reddit.
Well, then esports is really boring.
I know, right? You
still drama week?
Huh?
Still drama week.
Well, there wasn't really much drama at all. It was basically just...
Wasn't BlizzCon DDoS?
Yeah.
What?
BlizzCon was DDoS.
Their servers, I heard, huh?
Well, I mean, they never said it was DDoS.
It delayed, yeah, they were. They're very careful.
Didn't the electricity go out at one
point? Yeah, the electricity went out at one point, and then there was also a DDoS, and it took them like 6 hours or 7 hours to play two bests of fives.
Yeah. The funny thing was on the second day, they were DDoS until Hearthstone finished, and when Hearthstone finished,
Yeah, and so the funny thing is like everyone's like, StarCraft's alive, look at how many viewers it has, right? And I'm like, that's because there's nothing else fucking on, because you were DDoSed. And so Hearthstone is finished, World of Warcraft is finished,
Heroes
of the Storm is finished, and everything is showing StarCraft. It's the only tournament at BlizzCon, so it's like, of course everyone's going to watch it. It's, you know... It was okay though, like I enjoyed watching the games.
Yeah,
it wasn't like
I really liked the we were talking about the
The stage was amazing.
The stage was really, really
Did cool. you talk about the Overwatch?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We did talk about it. I was wondering.
You were salty
James
about
it?
Was he salty?
He loved it.
They've stolen some of my abilities, Trance.
He's gonna give
but
it.
But see nobody can tell that because you have you had an alpha.
You didn't show them.
But they weren't in the alpha, they were in my
They weren't
maybe this is what I was talking to Bruno in the car. I was like, maybe it's not such a great idea to always be so open about your ideas. There's somebody who can work faster than you will just come and be like,
everyone can work faster.
Copywriter. Well, that's a big point. Stop, you know, putting ideas on the table.
No, it's fine now because I've got like Tallyware Games and they're doing lots of work. I've got concept art to show you if you want
concept
to see.
Concept art, ooh,
yeah,
okay. Still the alpha demo thingy you have?
No, it's not in game. It's like their concept thing.
Yeah, but we still have that demo, the alpha.
Yeah, but it hasn't been updated because FireFrog needs to fix optimization, which is like, he was meant to be done like 3 weeks ago.
Okay. Okay. Cool. So that's going well. How's DreamHack? Dream League?
Oh, it's amazing. On Thursday, they ran matches.
I know.
And then they were like, "Oh yeah, yeah, we don't have the studio, so we're not commentating it." And I'm not here Thursday. And then I wake up, and I come back and I sleep, and I wake up and I see a thread going, "Why are the good studio so fucking lazy and didn't just grab a mic and commentate the games?" And I was like, why was everyone so lazy? And it's like, well, they said blah, blah, blah. But I think everyone was happy to see the end of phase one because it was such a shitstorm.
Oh, is it over now? Finally done?
Yeah, it's done.
Phase two.
This is like the fucking fourth time. Like, you're like, oh, you're going to DreamHack Monday.
Who qualified? Who qualified?
EG. EG,
C9.
Yeah.
Then you have Team Tinker, 4ASC, LGD, IG. VP and Empire, but I can give you the...
What's the name,
VP? VP Polar and Empire, and I can give you tell you now, Empire cannot come.
So who do you think is going to win? Trance.
EG Easy.
I think 4ASC.
4ASC,
yeah. Really? You have that much faith in the Finstack?
Dude, the Finstack is amazing.
But is it that amazing? That's the question.
It's the new align.
Because there's degrees of amazing.
They only lose because they have shitty ping from Finland.
Dude, that's an insult. It's like an insult. I've lived in Finland for a year.
But play USC's in Finland. You play like with 300
people. Didn't try, but fine. Fair enough. But that's okay. That's quite a few.
What
happened to Alliance? Did they fail?
They didn't qualify.
Ooh.
Which is probably the worst thing to happen to DreamHack because in terms of Swedish coverage, it's like...
Swedish.
Hey, so what games are you playing recently?
Nothing. I didn't have time to.
You're not playing.
I bought Football Manager yesterday.
Nice.
So at this rate, I'm going to be able to play it in 2 months when I get some time.
You know,
I try CSGO, but
Stuart
I didn't.
Stuart plays a lot of Football Manager.
Yeah, he actually knows all the guys, the whatever thingy. And I went to the office, to the London Twitch office, and there was this full swag of Football Manager glasses and coasters. And I was like, what the fuck is happening here?
Nice.
But I know. And actually, they work with Twitch.
Come with Stream Football Manager?
Yeah, they have an integration with Twitch. They have a thing in there. Yeah.
Like it's the most boring thing to stream.
No, if you actually like the game.
No. Don't get me wrong. Like, the game is good to play.
I would watch somebody that knows his shit, that takes, like, fourth division, whatever team, and I'll watch his progress go to the
Premier
League.
But, like, if you know how to play this game, it takes you literally, like, a week per week to do, because you just, like, do the training,
set up.
Stuart, when he's a commentator, when he goes to events, used to sit there, and then between commentating, he'd just play Football Manager. And he used to start a new Football Manager game every time he went to, like, an Intellectual Masters.
A new one.
So, Intellectual Masters, Stuart was just like playing football manager. And then it's like, time to cast CS, Stuart. It's like, okay, yeah. Damn.
I played Borderlands, the pre...
Oh, the pre-sequel. Yeah.
I got it, and I actually played it, me and Hannah and Raining Tea. We did co-op thing, you know.
Oh, really?
She enjoyed it a lot. I was just like, ugh, it feels so rehashed. It's literally
the same. It's the same thing, right?
It is the same thing. And it's even more annoying now, because you're playing some other shit planet, and you have oxygen to like always worry about, because it goes lower, and it's always it's refilled.
No.
I fucking hate those
It's
mechanics.
Like another thing on top.
It's like, what? It's because... people hate water
company,
levels.
What's
for
the company that makes 2K? Was
yeah.
Are they
yeah,
selling you oxygen tanks, free to play?
No. I mean, yeah, you have to go find them. It's just another thing to keep in mind all the time to refill. But it's 2K Australia made it, not the original, whatever, guys. So maybe that's why it's
Australians don't have oxygen.
I don't know. And there's all kinds of other... It feels very Australian. Like, yeah,
it feels really Australian.
It does. It's like all those small things.
Do you have like big spiders and snakes?
Yeah, there
game.
Are spiders. Yeah, actually are.
Huh.
And there's like some other small, I don't know, more like voice rate stuff. But yeah,
you have to check your shoes before you put your feet in.
What?
Yeah,
that's
your boots.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. You don't want to like...
That's what Toby still does that, apparently.
Who? Oh,
Toby one checks his shoes.
I shared a room in a hotel with him.
Yeah,
he
checks his shoes. Oh, God. For spiders. Yeah. I forgot the Australian.
Do you also have to check your underwear?
I don't know, maybe.
Well, there's a snake in there, usually.
Yeah. Is it the same as always?
Nah, but... Oh, shit, that's you. It's fine, because we can share.
Footsies.
Nah, but I don't know. You guys playing Dota, WoW. You're playing Dota.
I'm not playing Dota, Chance.
Yeah, you're a silencer, right?
I'm deciphering the metagame and winning.
By silencer. How does that work out?
Amazing.
Because I don't see a lot of silencer in pro play, I'm saying. Why haven't they caught up to it yet?
People don't realize. And also you can avoid those fights very easily if you're a pro. You can play around silencer.
You can avoid what? Around silencer?
Yeah.
How can you dodge the R button, man? It's like,
no, but
you just
you don't,
the
you
other
don't
way.
Need it. Yeah.
Like, when you go in, the silencer presses R, you run
just
that
up.
Way. You go in again. Press R, jump in, take Rex, get out. Press R, jump in, take Knight, Rex, get out.
That's
win.
Better heroes. In pub games, it's very good, though.
Yeah, fine. People don't turn the other way.
Yeah.
It's just like
let's commit.
Yeah, but Medusa, that would have been my tip for a good hero, because I was playing that, and then I came into pro, so that was all me.
Mm-hmm.
I think some people watched me play.
Medusa.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Mask of Madness, BKB, and then that way you can run and you can actually
you
get in front of people.
You mean the Vlaga build?
No, I
do you blink as well? Yeah.
Sometimes I have blink, but not.
So when they turn around, like you ult. And
yeah,
they turn
jump in front of
and you're just like, look at me.
Well, the thing is like you do support Medusa.
Right.
Oh, what?
Because you don't need items with Medusa.
No.
Oh, look, it's Semler.
Semler's calling me.
Where are you?
Hey, Semler!
Did you hear that? Hey.
Put him on speakerphone.
I don't know. He's.
No,
I don't want to put him on speaker. I'm at the house with the guys and.
Put him on speakerphone!
Bruno wants to say hi, see? He's screaming at me. But I was gonna be on my way there soon.
Call the girl!
Shut up, Bruno. As soon as I'm done here. So I don't know, like half an hour I think I should be there.
Call the dwarf.
You guys
call
not?
The dwarf.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, Pontus said it was finished earlier than 11.
Yeah, that was one of the best cards. Call the dwarf.
Oh, really? Was like a wipe
Jesus.
Something. 3-0. 3-1.
Who won?
Yeah, Bruno's asking. Fnatic. Oh, Swedish.
Fnatic won.
Awesome. Cool. Yeah.
You're like a pantomime.
But I'll be there in like half an hour.
But I was looking. Everyone was so bored, and you look
once
so asleep.
All right. Cool. See you soon, bro.
We talked about BlizzCon, but a lot of fun.
Dude, I love Tiddler. He's awesome.
Who?
Tiddler Celestial, the second place BlizzCon, which like he had like the funniest interview. When he got like from...
I didn't watch any of BlizzCon.
You didn't watch any of BlizzCon?
It's
Twitch,
boring.
Right?
Like, I don't like... Oh, I'm lying. Oh my god. I have watched one game of Heroes of the Storm.
Right.
The finals?
I was appalled.
Yeah. Appalled at which
teams played?
I had... It was the final. EG versus...
Who played
C9.
For EG?
G9.
Who played
Idra, Gamer, and
to.
Some other randoms. Never heard of. But what I was going to say is, I have the alpha for Heroes of the Storm for months. And I never got a chance to actually, you know, touch it, whatever. And now I watched the game for the first time. I literally watched the whole best of whatever. Yeah. And I was appalled because I couldn't imagine there can be a game that's easier and more casual than LoL. Even though, okay, I know you can't compare them. No, you can't compare them per se. I get it. They want to play it's a brawl or it's a whatever. But holy like, fucking shit, it was like...
He loves that game, by the way.
Skurf?
He plays Heroes.
He plays Heroes on the strong.
No, it's like, I get it. It needs to be superficial, no in-depth, whatever, fun, go fight, kill each other. Great, amazing. But I wouldn't do that over and over again. And then the casters, they're like so bad. Because they kept saying about the depth of the game and
3 days
how much, you know, how much bigger plays you can make and this. And all he was doing was saying, when this shit spawns, and oh yeah, they're trying to take this tower, and now they have to back off because these guys are cursed or whatever. And that was it. It was literally play by play by all, both of them. They're trying to give depth to it. And it's like, oh, it's so amazing. It's like, no. It's...
But what items they build, Trans?
I didn't understand anything, man. All I saw
what
was like...
What skills they go for?
There
I couldn't
no
tell.
Items,
there's I know there's no items. It was like... They just go and fight, and they increase
yeah,
the XP level
they
right?
go for, bro?
As they fight more, and
what?
That's going to get more
what
damage.
What skills did they go for?
Well, you can choose, like, the talents, right?
Yeah.
When you level up,
skills.
You can choose,
so
like, skills and talents. So you can actually, like, choose, like, a new skill.
I didn't understand much.
Or you can choose, like, to make one of the current skills, like, maybe have more range damage. Or...
And I heard when you're level 20, you can choose between an equivalent of a Blink and an Aegis. Is that correct?
Yeah, so
on
I think
some
guys
some,
had
some,
I think
some characters,
or something
yes.
like that.
But some had the equivalent of an Aegis, they would die in
yeah,
a few seconds.
Either Aegis or you can get a Blink Dagger.
Come
yeah,
back in
default.
Pay.
So, revive.
Blink Dagger had 40 second cooldown. It's not a Blink Dagger. Blink Dagger is like 30.
Well, you
okay.
get the point, like equivalent or something. It's like I was, no, I don't like this. So, if anybody wants an alpha access, you can take my key. I'm not gonna use it.
Well, the key is
but
your
Overwatch,
key.
Actually, I was intrigued by Overwatch. Even though it doesn't look hardcore, it looks like fun. Like, I would play that.
Yeah, but that's
because you like
battle
play.
Yeah, maybe.
Like,
it is kind of like TF2.
Like
yeah,
would,
get the boat,
you would shape
classes.
People in
it's like first person heroes.
But it looked
yes.
cooler than TF2.
It's an FP
like,
mode.
Yeah.
FP MOBA.
Yeah. I'll try that. That I'll try. That'll look fun.
That's what Firefrog called it. Firefrog wanted me to make an FP mode instead of like Reborn. Because he was like, people will play an FP MOBA in the future. And I was like, yeah, that sounds gay.
Mm. Fair
so imagine if you had been making an FMOBA.
And then I'd still have something shits in the bed. Because I'd be behind and I wouldn't have a cinematic. When I do a cinematic for Reborn, you're in it. It's going to do like, they'd be like, the graphics look like their real life. Because it is.
No, but like on the Hearthstone thing at BlizzCon, like when Tiddler advanced from quarterfinals to semi, and he was like, he had a chance to go for $50,000 if he won. It's like, well, I mean, of course you played in a lot of tournaments, but like you have secured $15,000. It was Rachel asking him, right? But like you have secured $15,000, which is probably higher than anything you ever won, right? Mm-hmm. And the guy's like, no, I actually played WCA and I won 32nd and I earned like $60,000. She's like, oh,
nice.
Well, it's still a lot of money.
Oh, you should have seen the price. No, the pre-game.
Rachel was probably too high to remember. Preparation.
You should have seen the pre-game production, whatever thingy for the Heroes of the Storm. Anybody watch that?
No.
It was in Control's wife.
Oh, when they were thrown from
that?
The teams.
That's nothing even. That,
no, I watched like that part and I'm like, God, I'm just going to watch something.
So the guy is like, it was her and the guy. And the guy's like, yeah, so now we're going to throw it to the game, guys. Thank you, blah, blah. And then she's like, ah, no, you know, comes in. Oh, actually, no, I think we have a video we're going to show you. I think. And they just look at the camera.
Jesus, Anna.
And the production rings. I was like, what? And they're trying to, you know, to get each other to BM each other in the team, and the guy was just like, no, nothing, super serious.
How do you...
Well, they were trying to interview them both and trying to get them to BM
yeah.
the other team.
Oh, yeah, that thing.
Kind of like...
Our game's
like,
really shit. No one's going to care unless you call this guy a Nazi.
Idra was sitting next to the captain of his team, and only the captain could talk or whatever. And I was like, I bet he's biting his tongue right now. Because the other guy was super decent, whatever. But the captain of C9 was just like, oh, I don't know, we know we're playing better or something like that. He was like a little cocky. But he was like, nah.
Lame.
And he got wrecked. So StarCraft 2 pros in, I don't know, it doesn't look so great so far. In HOTS or X pros.
Hey, they still, was it 100?
The other guys were low players.
But is it
players.
The best pro gaming retirement plan?
Is it?
Ever,
I think
yeah,
Hearthstone
because,
is the easier one.
When you
no,
finish
well,
being
you
a pro
just,
gamer, you don't
you
have a pension. So you just go click shit in HOTS and... Fucking Hearthstone.
Hearthstone, yeah.
And maybe soon Overwatch. Like, Blizzard is the retirement plan. Like, they said, Trance, you know, they wanted it, when they announced Overwatch, they wanted the game that their grandma could play. So they're really thinking forward. They want to keep Idra.
I see. Busy
until he's 80.
Retirement.
And then he's.
I wonder if just like maybe it's like Mike Morhaime or somebody's like, oh, I'm getting old for this shit. I need something easy.
Yeah. StarCraft.
I need something easier so I can still play.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's APM.
Chris Metzen. BlizzConnect. Community. No,
know.
Not the TV show. That one was cooler.
Yeah. But I guess it looked cool. It was cool, right?
It looked legit.
It looked legit, right?
Yeah, no, it looked
legit. Once a year, StarCraft gets
Metallica played. After
Metallica was
after the awful
like
level 90.
What?
Chieftain Warrior group.
What's his name?
Oh, yeah, the library. Was that Skid as well?
Yeah.
No, I bought the live ticket.
Yeah. What? There was a live ticket?
Cool.
Yeah, they have it on their own pitch, you know.
DirecTV,
like,
dude.
Yeah.
Been producing this comic since 2008.
Actually, ESL did part of it, so I don't know how much DirecTV did. Maybe the main stage.
ESL did the
Hearthstone, I know, for a
Hearthstone
and
something
else. Oh, StarCraft, okay.
I mean, WSS.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
So,
that was the only thing.
What do you think about future WCS with actually region-locked regions?
Too late, too little, too late.
Don't care.
Don't care, too little, too late.
What do you think about the new unit and the Cyclone?
Well, when is that launched?
Is it like end of... By, I'm guessing...
Beta was going to come early 2015.
Yeah, but like from beta hot until release, it was like... No, what's your Legacy of the Void?
Legacy of the Void is going to be a Sam loan.
You know, you're such a casual FPS player to actually look at Overwatch and say you'd enjoy playing that. What do you think is fun about Overwatch?
It just looked fun from the things and
Who's your favorite character?
Okay,
was it the gorilla?
No,
he's cool.
I didn't get to play the game, but from the presentation, because I went to the actual site and I looked, you know, you can see all the ability, all that shit, like separate videos.
Yeah.
And I got a feeling that most of the shit in there was OP and that made it fun for me. I was like, this looks fucking imbalanced and this looks imbalanced. So basically take one imbalanced thing to counter another imbalanced one. That's how it looked like.
Yeah, that's one way.
I know they're going to polish it and whatever, but that's what the only reason it looked fun. It's just kind of like so OP.
Do you like one-shotting people?
Have you played like Call of Duty, Advanced Warfare?
No, that's shit.
Have you played Team Fortress 2 much?
Very little.
You used to play Extreme
Counter-Strike. Counter-Strike, yeah, but it's fine. Like I said,
you play Battlefield?
Yeah, Battlefield. I play Battlefield though. Battlefield series more. But it's nothing like that. This is nothing like that.
Did you play any Hardline?
No, I didn't buy 4, I didn't buy Hardline, I was like...
Well, you got a free Hardline beta or whatever from...
No, I didn't bother. It just was like...
Did you play Loadout?
So,
okay.
Essentially what you're saying about the game was, you like the abilities.
Pretty much, yeah, that's what I thought the cool part was.
Yeah.
Yeah, just the way the good shit you could do. And I like this one skill that was in that game, James, where you could instantly flash yourself back 50 meters.
Yeah, what a great ability.
What a great
reminder,
yeah.
I gotta say.
I was pissed when I saw that.
I was laughing myself.
I was also pissed when I saw a hook. I was also pissed when I saw the track ability, where they can see people through walls for a limited period of time. I wasn't pissed when I saw mines, because that's dumb.
Here's the... Dun, 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 dun. Firefrog has been secretly consulting with Blizzard all this time.
Wow. Also, one of my movement systems.
As long as he's getting money out of that.
You know who played it? I think Tim played it, and I talked to him briefly. He said the movement needs a lot of work.
Yeah, of course. That's what's going to make or break this game.
I agree.
And
I mean, if the movement seems like super sluggish, I'm not going to fucking know. I can't. And if there's literally no option to even barely, like, not strafe jump, but like, you know, probably like...
Just gain, like,
have
a feeling of control.
Yeah, not just like fixed, you know what I mean? Like,
what is an example of a good FPS in paper about really bad movement?
In paper, you mean
like
everything
that sounds good, but it's like
the movement.
Movement sucks.
Movement.
Yeah. Like you said, movement kills an FPS. What FPS is shit because of the movement?
I think Call of Duty, Advanced Warfare.
Did you actually try that?
Yeah, he was playing.
I bought it, but the
why aren't you playing that? What the fuck?
I wanted to see what the cattle were
on PC, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I never played any Call of Duty, so I don't know.
Nah, but it's like they did exactly, I won't even say, but
Bring?
I designed a movement system for Call of Duty players, and they pretty much did what I did, but they made it feel shit.
Brink
was bad as well. Yeah, Brink was awful.
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Brink could have been good. I don't know.
Someone from chat said it.
It's like, it's not so much, it's not so much that you kill movement, like, oh, this movement is awful. It's just that the movement's not an enjoyable part of the game. Like, movement gets you from A to B. And I think that in an FPS game, movement is actually something to enjoy. You know? Like, I think that, like, in Dota 2, positioning and blink daggers and force staffs are an enjoyable movement experience.
Yeah, someone in chat had a good point. Flames WoW plays COD. James Harding.
No, I don't. I play Call of Duty.
You play Call of Duty, and we play WoW.
I played Call of Duty to see what people were doing.
I played World of Warcraft to see what...
You're not making a MOBA game! You're fucking lying.
Maybe not today, but maybe
yes,
tomorrow.
You are an explorer.
Exactly.
I watch it for the plot.
Thank you, Mr. Turk.
I didn't enjoy playing Call of Duty.
Did you see the Conan O'Brien thing about Call of Duty Advanced Warfare?
No.
You should watch
Conan O'Brien. It's fucking hilarious.
Dude, he made like a video about...
You know,
like,
they started to stream on Twitch, right? His team.
Yes,
yeah.
His team Coco.
Yeah, but they have it every week where he's like the useless gamer or whatever it is.
Yeah.
It's pretty funny, actually.
It was really funny. Like, I was watching.
He played Super Smash before.
Was he called the series Useless Games?
No, it's like the Useless Gamer or something. And they release a video every Sunday or something.
And they make him, like, play a game with someone.
He's just so good at
observational comedy. Like, Smash 4 and all that stuff. And it's just like, he says things that, like, as a gamer, you're like...
You're just used to it, like that's
how
it is. And then he's like, why?
Why the fuck?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And it's just like, it's so funny.
I've got to watch that.
Yeah.
So what's the advice?
It's up on Team Coco on their YouTube. It's a lot, they have a lot of cool things.
I watched a lot of his stuff. I went through like lots of Team Coco YouTube and he did lots of stuff. I was like, this guy's really fucking good at his job.
Yeah. Have you played any of the Call of Duties before?
Call of Duty 4 was pretty fun.
No, not 4. That was the only good one I heard from.
Yeah,
Black
I played 4.
But after, like, any of the other... any of the
was
other.
It?
No, we didn't.
But I think they were made sometimes by, like, different teams.
No, but it
wasn't
after.
So they kind of, like, they came out...
Modern Warfare 2, right?
Because when I looked at this Advanced Warfare sheet, it was just, like, had some different things, as in the futuristic sheet, whatever, but still for, like, the same kind
Modern
of...
Modern Warfare was the one I...
Monkeys running around trying to shoot.
Yeah.
And that one was pretty meh in terms of multiplayer. Like, I was watching a guy. He was like,
played those two for the, like.
He was shooting. Okay, how did you find the guns in Call of Duty? Is there like any difference or impact? I was watching a guy who was shooting a guy like literally at the end of the other map because it was small and there's no fucking recoil on his gun. He was just like.
You can put on a steady thing that steadies your aim.
Yeah.
Basically,
no recoil.
You start the game and you have like the guns. You pick the one that you like. And as you get headshots with it and stuff, you unlock things you can put on it. So
that
basically, you feel like you get better because you're like,
easy.
I can kill people now.
But it's just
but in reality,
you.
It's game progression making you better.
Helping with the thing.
Yeah. And I even think that when you first...
Is that single player or multiplayer?
Multiplayer. And I even think that when you first get in, they give you kills based on like, you know, when you're a new player, like you insta-kill somebody when actually, in fact, you shouldn't have. So as a new player, as long as you put your cursor over somebody in your first multiplayer game or something, you let you kill. Because like, it was started off like that for me, and then it felt like it got a little bit harder. And then when I unlocked weapons, it got easier, and I felt better. But the game, like, it's a horror, like, I don't, there's so many things that I don't like about, like, there's lots of, like, have you ever watched, did you watch the new South Park on Free to Play?
Yep.
So South Park did an episode about free to play games, right? You should watch it, it's really good. And it kind of feels that there's elements, even in like Call of Duty, that are kind of like, you know, instead of having, you don't care about your frags and deaths.
Yeah, give me some water.
Because you have score. But your score goes up drastically depending on how you kill people. So long shot, you get 100 and blah, 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 blah. And even if you, even if you're dying, and then you kill the guy that killed you, you get like a payback.
Yeah,
and
like,
even if you're doing really shit, and then you kill someone randomly, you get comeback, which is like 200 points or something, right? So the thing is like, at the end of the game, you look at the score and you go, oh, I did this. But in reality, score doesn't mean shit. But they try and make you focus on the score.
Then kills,
then kills and deaths. So that you think that you're, you know, not
pretty
as
good,
bad as you
okay.
are. And the way that they give you these kind of like rewards as you're playing is like kind of like meant to make you feel good, because everyone can like, it's quite easy to kill people in Call of Duty, like literally just, you know, it's not hard.
So inventory.
Yeah, and then, you know, so to get better at the game, it's all about like being able to know when you can get a kill and get out of a situation and fighting in the right areas. But they use a lot of like, yeah, psychology, and I don't particularly enjoy that. And so...
Well, I get it, it's for the masses. Yeah. Same as many others.
Yeah.
We're the elitistic hardcore. So, you know.
Yeah, I'm gonna put it in my game, but I'm just going to like give fake points to people. So that even if you're doing really bad, I always make sure you're halfway up the scoreboard. But on everyone else's scoreboard, you'll be at the bottom.
That's a good psychological thing.
Did you ever play Monday Night Combat? Monday Night Combat. It's like that game felt like you were rewarded for everything. It's like you picked some churros, and the game was like, "Oh, you got some churros!" And it just like keeps going.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun though.
In Call of Duty,
I think it was because a lot of things were going on.
Yeah. In Call of Duty, they don't give you items like drops per se, like in like CS or Dota. What they actually do is they give you temporary items, so you get like a blood mask for 30 minutes.
Oh, it's just like,
keep playing.
Are you talking about like cosmetics? Or
like in-game minutes?
So you get a cosmetic, for 30 in-game minutes.
Okay, so you can keep it for tomorrow and play tomorrow.
Yeah, like...
It would be really evil if it's like, you can use it for the next 30 minutes, hurry up.
And then it's like, it's kind of like meant to be like a, you know, a preview of like, hey, you can wear this, but now it's gone, you should go buy it, kind of thing.
Oh, you can buy it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But you get it for like a small period of time. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, maybe it works. Funny. There actually is some pasta if you want some pasta.
Maybe I'll eat something before we leave. Maybe.
And they keep people playing with this really annoying progression system, which is like unlock things for individual weapons and, you know, individual perks. And you have to get like 10 headshots with this weapon to unlock the, you know, laser sight.
Mm.
So you pick this, you know.
Mm. Oh, sounds boring.
It is.
I really like the new,
like, talking about
Goblins versus Gnomes.
Expansion. Yeah,
that's
good. More cards in a card game is better.
It's better.
Because that's essentially what allows players to show their personality outside of the actual gameplay, is like playing a deck a very specific way.
Yeah.
And the more cards, the less chance there is of people copying each other's decks. You don't see the same druid deck.
Mm-hmm.
Which we spoke about earlier.
And you just like, hopefully you will see priest decks that are not based around how can I solve priest and circle of healings, or I don't know, paladin decks that are not based on equality, consecration.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, maybe you'll see them still, but like...
Did you like my hair trends?
I was telling Bruno it looks amazing earlier.
I shaved it.
You still have the hint of grey here.
I shaved it, and then I haven't had a cut, so it's the same length
the
way around. You remember I shaved my head for TI?
Yeah.
I haven't had my hair cut since.
Oh.
No, I did. Did
you
I?
You did.
TI
Yeah, remember that we went with... Tan. And he was like, you guys are smart, like you.
Yeah, but I'll pay for our haircuts.
Yeah.
Because we were like, I think my hair's fine, but if you guys want us to cut it, you know, sure.
And Tan was like, there, take the cut. Like, you guys are fucking smart.
Fuck it.
Alright. Mm.
Drink.
Nah, I'm done. I drank water. Water's good.
Dude, it's. Not water.
Oh,
it gave me
vodka.
Vodka?
Oh, shit, I couldn't even tell the difference, man.
No,
should be. I guess you need to get dressed and shit, so.
Nah.
Maybe you should wrap it up. Well, alright.
He's going with the casual look.
Yeah.
Well, it's. He's a monk. Yes, Coral.
How are you getting there?
I'm gonna Uber it.
Can I join the city?
Sure.
Uber!
It's for rich trans. Where do you get the money from?
Amazon, bro.
Wow!
Amazon dollars.
Such Amazon money.
Amazon,
I know, right?
Esports money.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Mm. We probably have news about the future of Twitch trans.
Oh, maybe should we mention anything about the other thing?
Yeah, actually we will. That's what I was heading towards.
Sorry, I'm more annoyed.
Wait. Did you know about Sujo's robot?
Yeah, I actually was, when he was testing it, I was like talking to him, and I was, but actually the robot was talking to him through me, which was pretty cool.
Oh, so you tested it before he went live
with him? I mean, he went live with like 20 people, trans actually told me. It's pretty cool.
Oh. He wants to come around the house.
Yeah, I told him, like, I should come around.
What do you want to say about Twitch?
So this Saturday.
Am I fired? Is this what's happening?
We just fucking got you back. Why the fuck are you fired? Like, are you feeling guilty, James? Is this something I don't know?
Bruno does all my work.
Besides that, I don't really know.
No, he doesn't. You just always think that.
So next Saturday, 15th of November, circa 5 p.m. CET, or is it CST?
I know you're going to know.
CET. You keep going.
No, go do it.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, if then you know.
Hey, what's happening?
We're organizing something little cool for the community, we hope.
Yes.
It's Twitch who is taking this initiative.
It's Twitch!
Just making sure.
Twitch.
It's a Twitch-run initiative organized by these two fellas. Go on, Bruno.
And
it's
just me. Yes. Twitch!
So we're basically... It's basically what we're doing. On the 15th of November, with Twitch TV, we're kind of trying to see the concept of doing a...
Single day
fun tournament... that is actually streamed on the players and the community's stream. So what we're doing is we're inviting four pro gamers, and they're going to play a 2v2 mid with four celebrities, and each pro gamer will have a celebrity, if you know what I mean, and it's going to be Dota 2 related, and there's going to be city rules in place to make the games a bit more fun. So you might get 0 points if you're a pro gamer and you get a kill, but you might get 2 points if you're a celebrity and get a kill. So
or something like that.
Something like that. And they're going to do a streamed kind of like tournament for you guys, the community on Twitch. And hopefully you find it fun and enjoyable. And since it's like a Twitch thing, there might actually be prizes for the streamers, maybe like Twitch
yes.
icon.
Twitch related.
Yeah, like, so, and the way that we're trying to think of it is like, if we do something for Dota 2 like this and it's fun, we can promote streamers. And then hopefully in the future, we can get more and more people in these kind of tournaments across Twitch. If you're a Twitch streamer and you're... Yeah. You know, like, you know, you want, you know, access to these tournaments. This is kind of a test run, and we'll see how it goes.
Okay.
And we have, in the tournament, playing...
Well, I mean, let's start with the personalities.
Yeah.
We have LD, that's going to be playing. We have Cybermat, going to be playing. We have Pyrion Flex, and we have Total Biscuit.
Yes. So we have the old men.
You have
celebrity
the
bracket.
Old men.
Or old looking men. Celebrity bracket. Sorry, Yogi. And
then from the players, we have this guy called No Tail. We have this other guy called.
You mean Big Daddy?
Big Daddy No Tail.
Sorry,
yeah.
Big Daddy.
Come on.
We have this other guy called Sing Sing. This guy is kind of new, is Dendy, I think. And this guy that streams pretty much every day called Puppy. Of course. So the teams are going to be Puppy and Cybermat.
Maybe we should announce the full teams.
No, we can announce it.
No, that's fine.
Yeah,
Puppy and Cybermat.
I'm just saying, because we didn't really confirm with them, hey, you're going to play with this guy.
No, I confirm with most of them.
Yeah.
Total Biscuit will play with Dendy.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah.
That's going to be fun. Dendy's going to have to tell, like, Total Biscuit's the guy that's like, he's played Dota, but he's going to, like,
I'm not going to say his MMR in public.
He's lower in MMR than everyone else, but not.
But
that
not that
much
bad
more.
As you think.
No,
yeah.
No, it's not that bad.
Biscuit.
No, his MMR I think is in 3K-ish.
Yeah, that's wrong.
Yeah, that's it.
So
maybe just below.
So the thing is, No Tail will play with Pyrion Flex.
Yeah.
And Sing Sing will play with LD. And that's gonna be a lot of flaming.
The flamer.
And for balance, because like people will say like, okay, here's the
Sing
thing.
Sing Sing
right?
And LD would probably be.
Yeah.
Or Puppy and Cybermat would be good.
Yeah, so the thing is, every single player...
We're going to balance it. That's the point.
Gets different...
So, here's the thing. Like, the rules of the tournament... I mean, it's like, we already talked to Jane Dora and Ghost of Gamers, so it's going to get published tomorrow. So, like, there's no point...
Now we're in the announcement for, like, Ghost of Gamers and shit, because people want to read it from their website, and they want the hits, and now someone's just going to post it on Reddit, and Ghost of Gamers are going to hate you.
Yeah, damn it. Well, maybe Ghost of Gamers won't publish it.
It's
but anyways,
there's gonna be a lot more to me. Bruce is giving the gist.
Yeah. So the way it works is, like, you have to get to a certain amount of points, but the certain amount of points depends on the team.
Yes.
So for example, for Total Biscuit to win, they need to get to 3 points, but for LD and Sing Sing to win, they need to get to 8 points. How do you get a point? You get a point if the personality or celebrity gets a kill or a tower last hit. If he doesn't get the kill or the last hit, it doesn't count.
Yeah.
So if Sing Sing just dominates...
You need to set them up, basically.
Yeah,
like,
the pro player needs to get the person low, and Total Biscuit
this
needs to press
the
button.
imagine if you miss it. Oh, I mean,
like,
dude, the best.
I hope the games don't go on so long because
that's the second rule,
okay,
right? By 15 minutes, the game ends automatically, and you look at the personality CS to see who wins, and then again, there's a multiplier. So TV gets like 3 times as much CS, for example,
then
as LD.
Yeah.
So if LD like gets, like say Total Disc gets 10,
so basically
LD gets 25.
Need to support as much as they can personality.
The pros need to like get all the last hits, get all
the last hits.
Yeah. Like the pros need to get like all the like.
I wonder what heroes they're gonna play for that though.
Like, it's all pick,
so
whoever picks faster.
Oh, and it's all pick, and it's like all the heroes allowed.
Yeah, yeah.
So you need to be like super fast if you wanna make a combo or whatever, so you don't get. No.
Or you don't, or you wait until like the combo.
Cybermat
and Poppy is gonna be fast with that.
I know what they want to play. I know what they want to play.
Oh, I bet Big Daddy picks, what's it? Magnus and Rubik or something. And he's like, lift, lift.
ES4. But he's not going to have an S4 anymore.
LD's not. Or
all right. But they're all going to be streaming on their own personal channels, and this is to kind of grow
their fan bases.
And
their subscribers.
And also, yeah, and their subscribers. So when you watch it, if you enjoy it, make sure you support them, because it's Twitch that are organizing this for them. And then they actually will win like icons and you know, stuff for their accounts. So it's actually quite nice. And then in the future, if this is successful, we want to involve more and more community members. And it's not like, you know, even though we're the people kind of organizing it, there's, you know, there's no kind of coverage. The coverage is you go watch Sing or Total Biscuit's channel or Pyrion and stuff. And then hopefully in the future, it kind of grows in size and we meet lots of more
Maybe expand other games as well.
Yeah,
you know, we're gonna look, see how. It's a test.
But it should be fun. It's only one day. I would definitely watch
hours.
That shit.
Next Saturday. What's the name we saw on?
Twitch is Double Trouble.
Okay, Twitch is Double Trouble. We couldn't find anything better, faster.
Oh, is that
name.
What we did?
Double Trouble.
Make it double.
Wait.
Protect the world from devastation.
Are they cool with the rules?
Unite all
people
within our nation.
Yeah, they loved it.
Okay, good.
They all loved it.
So
here we go. So that's that.
That is that.
We denounce the evil of truth and love.
I'm glad you came out with the second rule.
Oh, the CS?
Standard
rules. Yeah.
I know his game's been going on for a whole lot.
Yeah.
Well, I came up with like the first rule because I was like, it can't be fun if the pro gamers can just win and the guys just stood there. And then I was like, I haven't heard what you did. So the second rule is really good. That's fun. And the way it ends, it's really good.
Yeah,
because I was worried they would, the pros would take all the CS, control the game, and then they'd be like, just pick Lich.
And get a chain for us. But
that
way, like, you force
it. It's 2v2 mid for whoever's asking in chat. That's what's going to be 2v2
Yeah, no jungling allowed.
But you realize if one team's ahead on CS, they can play really defensive and then not take the fights to allow
but
the
But they
points.
Still need to
but
farm.
But you can still farm and just run.
Farm what? Where? You're gonna see.
No, farm the creeps in the middle.
That's all you can farm.
Do you get any
think about
are
it.
You gonna risk that?
True. I mean, if you get. Because you're gonna give away.
It's not like they're playing for $1 million here, James. You know, it's fun.
I mean, you know, I don't
know. I don't know about you. Maybe
fun.
You're that, I don't know, maniac. Or
we had this conversation earlier.
You really play a game for fun.
Oh, I see.
He plays to win.
Play to win. Fair enough.
That's why people are like, they don't understand why my MMR is so high, even though it's like I'm playing Silencer. I can actually play a lot of heroes in this role, but I don't play the fun. I play to win, so I just work out like the map in terms of like where things are going to happen and why we're losing. Learn to win.
Cool. But sounds good.
Cool. Alright, let's go get
that's
drunk.
Out of the way.
Let's
go get
socialized.
Alright, thanks for watching.
Thanks
good
for
meal.
Watching,
We still don't know what we're doing with the show. More than welcome to go on our subreddit and make some suggestions. And
we're not going to have a good meal next weekend because between the Twitch thing on Saturday and Dream League starting on Monday,
I'm
pretty sure that we won't have the time.
No time. For food.
No
we won't even eat.
Yeah, and also people will probably crash at the house. It's going to be crazy.
And also the reason why we don't have a normal studio up and running? It's because some people are sleeping everywhere in the house.
Waga
yeah.
is sleeping in the studio room.
Where is Waga?
He's
in
went
the
home
studio
for
room.
A day.
He didn't come to the...
He went, no, he went
to
home.
Oh,
he
left today
he's
to Skåne.
Back on Tuesday or Wednesday.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Time to shut this motherfucker up. Did you mute sound?
No, I haven't done anything.
Okay, I'll do it.
How you
downstairs.
Good, how are you, man? Still on there, so.
Hi, everyone.
Bad with me, man. Fucking tired, man.
Tired. Is that the magic pasta?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll put it on, I'll try it.
Thank you, Coral. You have to put it in the microwave, of course.
You?
Yeah. You have to, because otherwise you don't have to do anything.
Well, it's just like the cheese thing without it being melted. It's not that fun. Or tasty. Let me go get popcorn.
Fair enough.
Are we going fast?
I'm gonna eat first and then
yep,
go.
Yep.
Yeah. I wonder if Uber comes this far here.
Yeah, they did. I booked a lot of time.
Oh. Wait, Bruno!
Come on! What the fuck? Well, how are you?
Let's see.
I don't know if you're off.
We should be off.
Tired, busy, same old, same old. What are you doing? Well, now I'm gonna go to Frankfurt and talk to people.
Yeah.
That's number one. And then I can do a lot more shit, like Dota 2 stuff.
Yeah.
Because I'm taking over Dota 2 stuff at Twitch. That's gonna be the number one. Let's put myself to kill that and
invite you. Are we needed? I'm guessing we're needed.
So yeah. One more work,
huh? I'm guessing we're needed?
I don't know. I hope. I don't.
Oh, right.
I didn't say anything super.
I didn't say anything super.
I think
the
walkway.
Super sensitive.
Hey, let's do the walkway.